I loved reading, and I loved things like puzzles and coloring, and didn't really speak until I was fairly old. I was real shy, and I just would get lost in books. And so I do remember when I was about 8 years old seeing Where the Wild Things Are for the first time, and I was already a reader of words, but what floored me about that book was the three-page turns where Max's room turns into a forest, and I just was blown away by that. I mean, I felt like it was a miracle. I could not believe that somebody could make this common child's bedroom turn into a forest with just three-page turns, and I just wanted to grow up and figure out how he did that and learn how to do it myself. It took a while for me to come up with what Clementine looked like. I mean, in the manuscript, she's, of course, described as having unruly red hair. I kind of knew from the manuscript that, I'm trying to think back to what I knew at that time, that she didn't play it by the rules, you know, and that she had an artist mother and a father who was the manager of an apartment building. So her parents didn't go to traditional jobs, and I figured, because of that, she's kind of got a quirky home life. And so there are kind of clues that way as to what she would look like. But I also looked very carefully at Lewis Darling's illustrations in the Beverly Cleary books, because I wanted the book to harken back to that era. And I wanted the design of the book and the font and, you know, all the elements of page layout to look as if that book had come from that time. So there's sort of this combination of wanting it to look fresh as paint as well as like something that had been around long enough to be a classic. And so that was a line I was trying to follow, you know, I was trying to be in that area. And I do kind of aim for that with most of my work, I think. Now that I say that, I think that's probably true. And so I did a whole lot of drawings of her, some of which were too cartooned, and then others were too realistic, and finally arrived at what she looks like. Just trial and error, just took a long time. And I think it's a process of, you know, drawing until I recognize her. It's like I feel like, you know, she's there. I just, no, that's not her yet. No, that's not her yet. You know, so there's a lot of erasing. And then, you know, with her, I had this one image, and I thought, okay, that looks sort of like her. And then I started using, you know, that character and put her into a narrative sequence. And actually, she was sitting outside of Principal Rice's office in the chair, in her various positions in this chair. And it was in drawing her doing all that I kind of got to know her. It was like, okay, I get you. Now I know who you are. The book that just came out is A Couple of Boys Have the Best Week Ever, and it actually began as a thank you note that I wrote to my editor's parents, because my youngest son and her son spent a week at her parents' house, my editor's parents' house, going to this nature camp. The boys were invited to come stay at their house on the beach and attend a nature camp for a week. And so my son and her son, you know, went to this beach house of this, actually it's not their beach house, it is their house, and it's right on the sand in Malibu. It's this beautiful place. And they went to this nature camp every day. And so my editor's dad would drive the boys to nature camp in the morning and pick them up and drive them home. And then the boys would just hang out at my editor's son's grandparents' house for the rest of the day. And when this week was over, I brought the boys back to my house to kind of hang out with my older sons. And during that time, my editor called me, and she's like, you know what would be really great is if you could write my folks like a thank you note in the form of a book. And, you know, maybe do some drawings, and maybe the boys can help you. And I thought, you know, of course I'm going to write her folks a thank you note, but in the form of a book, you know, this is kind of a lot to ask. And I'm like, okay, sure. And so I sat down and I wrote like a very quick thank you note in the form of a book. And the boys drew some pictures, and we sort of slapped it all together, and I sent it to her folks. And they thought it was hilarious, and they made a copy and sent it to my editor down in the publishing house in San Diego. And she passed it around to all her colleagues. And then she called me and she said, you know, there's something here, this little book that you made for my folks, there's something here that you should maybe think about doing a book. And I thought, how could there be something in this very specific thank you note that, you know, of a very specific week and these experiences that do not have a universal ring to them. I just can't imagine that there's anything here. And the backstory of that is that I had been trying to write another story for probably 6 months and sending her these drafts, and she'd say, like, you know, it's just, it's not in your voice. I don't, and I'd say, well, what's my voice? And she said, your voice is kind of like, it plays straight man to your illustrations. And so when she got this thank you note, she said, you know, this is in your voice. This is exactly what I was talking about. And so I had this little Xerox thank you note on the floor of my car from like August until after Christmas. And so I'm driving my oldest son back to the airport to go back to college. And he picks it up off the floor of the car and he's reading it and he's cracking up. He's like, what is this? And I told him. And he took it in the airport and he's checking in with his e-ticket, and you know, he's at the security gate and he's still reading it. And I'm kind of close to tears because he's going back to college. And he was just cracking up and he handed it back. He said, that is hilarious. You should do something with that. So I think it was at that point I started to think about it as a real book. And it went through 25 revisions of text and probably 10 dummies of just trying to get this very particular experience of this week to work as a picture book that would be more universal. And so what has resulted is this book called A Couple of Boys Have the Best Week Ever.
For more author interviews, recommended reading lists, and information about teaching kids to read, please visit us online at www.readingrockets.org.